welcome to Top Gear. On tonight's programme, James May does the business in this new S-Type Jaguar. DIY is fine if you're building a wardrobe, but what if you're making a car? Brendan Coogan gets his kit out. And Quentin Wilson saves himself a paltry $6,000 buying a European bargain.
It's absolutely disgusting.
All right, Niggas, run us through the job one more time.
Here's the French bank. Squealer here turns up in his motor with his phony European cash card and takes the dough from the hole in the wall. And once Squealer's got the dosh, we trouser the Wonga, head back to Blighty and change the francs down at Thomas Cook's. Piece of cake. All we need is a decent motor.
Oh! Sorted. I have bled a BM from BMW UK and they never suspected a thing.
Now look here, boss. I'm not driving a BMW. What this job needs is something tasty. I'll do it in a small Jaguar, nothing else.
Brilliant. They don't do a small Jaguar and they haven't done one since 1968 in the S-Type.
Boss, you've been inside for too long. There's a new S-Type out, a real Jag, a nice motor. And I think I know where I can get hold of one.
Ah, old Needles might be a bit of a wide boy, but I've got to hand it to him for knocking off this new Jag. Back in the days when a new suit cost 2 and 6 and everything was made of real wood, Jaguar was very successful in this class. First, with the Mark II in 1959, and then later in 1963, with the revised S-Type. So unless you've been in a coma since Ronnie and Reggie were sent down, it's easy to see where the inspiration for this car came from.
Does this shape look familiar? Yes, it's Inspector Morse's car, isn't it? A genteel car for bowling down the genteel leafy lanes of Oxfordshire, solving genteel crimes.
Is it Eckers-like?
In their day, the Mark II and S-Type were nothing of the sort. They were arch-crooks cars because they were fast, they were cheap and they handled brilliantly. In fact, they were so good in the wrong hands that the cops had to buy them as well, trading in their panda cars for a decent chance of apprehending the miscreants. 60 miles an hour in under 7 seconds. But if that's not enough for your getaway, you can also have a 4-litre V8, the same engine that you get in the bigger Jags. There's double wishbone suspension all round, and never mind exactly what that means, it's what you get on a Ferrari, which is all you need to know. There's rear-wheel drive, traction control, 50-50 weight distribution. Blimey, it's gonna blow my bloody doors off!
Yes, I know. Jaguar is owned by Ford these days, but so what? I hear some people cry that this V6 is distantly related to one you can have in a Mondeo. But so what? And yes, I know, this car was loosely based around the underpinnings of Ford's new Lincoln model. But so what? I would like to point out that the Jaguar S-Type was designed, conceived and is built by the excellent men and women of Albion. And it's made at Castle Bromwich, in a factory that used to produce Spitfires. That'll give BMW and Mercedes something to worry about.
But I'm not Neville Chamberlain, and I'm not going to underestimate what Jaguar is up against. The S-Type has to take on the might of the BMW 5 Series, the Mercedes E-Class, and the Audi A6. But if it's successful, it should double Jaguar's output. It's a crucial car for Jaguar and St. George.
Now, anyone who ever had a picture of the E-Type on their bedroom wall will know that Jaguar is a sporting marque, but it should also be a luxury car. And it is. There's wood, and the seats are swathed in lovely leather, very aromatic and very, very creaky. But it's not all nostalgia. This dashboard is beautifully laid out, and there are gadgets galore. There's an excellent hi-fi, you can have satellite navigation, you can even have voice activation of these functions, so you can talk to the car and it will obey your every command. It's homely, but high-tech, even if there is a faint whiff of old fart about it.
When I first saw the motor, I thought, nah, too retro. A car so backward-looking that it really should be turned round and driven everywhere in reverse.
But I'm starting to like it. I really am. I like the way this rear end imitates the bigger Jag saloons.
Nice.
I like this feline arch in its backbone.
Tasty.
And I love these 10-spoke wheels.
Cushy.
And I like the four lights with a hint of the original cowls.
Packer. Not sure about that grille, though. Makes it look a bit like a dead haddock. Well, I'll soon sort that out.
With the help of this Coventry screwdriver.
Rather better made than they used to be.
Anyway, I've got a serious job to do. Let's go to work.
This new S-Type is perfect for the job. It is, pauses to light pipe, a proper car and a real Jaguar. It has a reassuring weightiness to it. The steering is meaty, the gear change beefy, the ride firm but compliant. It feels like a great British car should. Crooks, go for this V6 manual. Golf club chairman, you want the V8 automatic. It's more waftable. Jaguar will do me a good finance deal, but as everybody knows, you're better off with cash. Prices start from £28,300 for a V6, rising to £37,600 for a top-of-the-range V8. Hang on, I've got the car and the cash. Sorry, boss, but I'm going straight. Straight down the Costa del Crime to set myself up. Lovely!
Next week, the old Toyota Starlet was a dog. Is the new Yaris any better? And the Lancia Integrale, according to Quentin, the most exciting thing to come out of Italy since Sophia Loren.